Welcome to this year's Eurobike. It's once again bike paradise. But not only, and that's the reason why we'll be talking about the future of mobility in this episode, we will concretely look at light electric vehicles and their purpose for the mobility transition. So are you ready? Let's go to Hall 8. I'm on my way to Hall 8, meeting Konrad Otto Zimmermann, who is the creative director of the Urban Idea, a studio committed to future mobility and sustainable urban development. I'm looking forward to meeting him. Konrad, you're a real expert when it comes to fine mobility as well as sustainable mobility. And I would like to start out with, what's special about light electric vehicles?
Well, light electric vehicles can have two, three, four wheels, one, two, three, four, five seats. They can have a speed range far beyond the 45 kilometers that we know from the speed pedelec. They can actually be much more efficient and much more energy saving and much more climate friendly than cars.
This sounds actually very promising, but wouldn't you say that LEVs might be competition to bicycles?
There is a market for all these vehicles. We have to grow the market. We have to come to a shift from the big cars. Then we can come to a fine mobility ecosystem that we need to work towards.
What role do LEVs play when talking about a sustainable and climate-friendly future?
Well, LEVs are essential for a climate-friendly and sustainable urban mobility and also regional mobility. The bicycle only has one-fifth of the weight of the rider. Light electric vehicles may have 10 times or 12 times the weight of the rider or the driver, so that's much more efficient. And then electric is, of course, better than combustion engine and can actually carry people over longer distances and with more heavier weight than you can do with a bicycle.
Now, last question, Konrad. How do you get from A to B?
Well, usually I walk as much as possible. When it's a longer distance, I take the bicycle, and beyond that, the train.
Sounds very sustainable. Thank you so much. And for me, I'll now meet other people. Thank you, Konrad. Have a great day.
Very welcome.
Bye-bye. We know now what LEVs are. I really now want to find out what innovations arise in that special industry. And I'll now meet Christoph Neye, who's the co-founder of Motion Lab Berlin, a Berlin innovation hub that is focusing on hard tech innovation. Hi, Christoph. It's great to meet you. You have a quite good feeling of the industry, and I would like to know from you what ideas and innovation actually currently arise.
So right now, I think the most innovative things are in the detail. So it's not about the big vehicles, the development in new segments, but it's more, they're getting more efficient, they have better range, they are more comfortable, so it can really compete with a car or a transporter because they're getting much more down to the detail and getting better every year. So I would say that's already a great development right now.
So Christoph, do you really think that LEVs can compete with cars?
Right now, it's more important than ever that they try. And I think the light electric vehicles, they should just get out there on the street to show that they are available competition and they can compete, and they need infrastructure.
If you could dream of the perfect world, how would the future of mobility in your eyes look like?
So in regards to future of mobility, I think an even better diversification, more models, more options for specific usage would be a really good answer to the ubiquitous car. If we can do more things that are specialized, more practical, what I actually wanted to do, we can have the change that we are looking for. And then the cities will change accordingly. So the ideal future of mobility is everyone is willing to try something new. Because if they try, they will realize it's possible to switch away from the car.
Appreciate it, Christoph. And for you, it's time to go for the academy stage, right? For me, it's now time to actually look at some LEVs and talk to some manufacturers. Let's go. Hello, Pierre. Nice to meet you. Pierre, you are the co-founder and CEO of Sixi. Yeah. You are innovating a real nice paddling system that is chainless, but in addition, you started manufacturing, or let's say prototyping, this real great light electric vehicle, or you call it active vehicle. So what exactly is it, and why did you come up with that idea?
Right, it's actually working. This one is more than a prototype, it's a working prototype. And the idea is to activate transfers, right? So when you step in your car, what happens is you just sit in your car and you're gonna go do 30 kilometers to go to work, drive back home, and you have spent a day completely passive, no activity, no physical activity, which is, in my mind, dreadful. So we decided to try and change that. So we create an active vehicle. You have to pedal to move.
So the goal is of really giving people the safety of a car, but at the same time, making them active so they have to actually do some things.
It's definitely that. You can go on the highway. You can pedal 120 kilometers an hour.
What?
It's homologated though. But you need a driving license, of course.
Yeah. Okay, how about you show me your vehicle a little bit closer, I mean the prototype, so I can get a feeling of what that all includes, right?
You need to be surprised then.
Yes.
Let's go. First thing is the pedaling device there. So you understood it's electronic. No chain,
yeah.
Optics like a bike really. The driving is very special, it's a recumbent bike position, it's all drive-by-wire, all pedaling by-by-wire, and the last thing is the tilting, which is active and also by-wire. So when you drive in road mountains, for instance, you have this great feeling of driving a motorbike, but you don't need to be a pilot to do that, because it's all the vehicle that does the calculation itself of the position.
Nice.
So it's really smooth, easy, and quite an experience, actually.
Do you have brakes other than that?
You do. You can brake on, like on a bike there. And the steering system is also by wire, like the pedaling device. So you can... This position there is really original. It's like a recumbent bike. It works fine, and it's all regenerative braking first, then gets to mechanical. Voila, the best of two worlds, as you said, biking and car safety and speed.
Good. Thank you so much. I wish you good luck. And next year, I really want to ride that one.
Well, you can come sooner.
Perfect. Great. Thank you, Pierre. Bye-bye. Software and digitalization is an incredible, important key part when talking about the mobility transition. And I'll now talk to Anna Buchmann, who's the co-founder and CEO of Noka. And I really want to find out what importance digitalization really has for the LEV industry. Nice to have you here, Anna. Can you explain what your company is doing?
Noka Mobility digitalizes procurement and supply chain processes in the cycling industry. We're starting with cycling, but then we want to go obviously into other LEV categories as well. You can imagine it as a digital bridge between component suppliers and OEM vehicle manufacturers. Right now, the procurement processes are really manual, and they're being done by email, by Excel sheets, by phone. There's so much incredible data you can actually use, and we help our customers to make it more efficient, to have an optimized process, and then use this data to build more transparent, more resilient, and more efficient supply chains.
This sounds actually really, really good, and eventually more efficient than it probably is right now. So what would you say, how are you with that solution helping the LEV industry?
I strongly believe so. So we're starting in cycling because there's already an industry here. I think in LEV, we have so much potential of what's going to come. We can't even imagine the type of vehicles that are going to be on our roads in 5 to 10 years' time. So we believe that components are coming. There is new components being developed right now, and we want to bring them on our platform to give them transparency and visibility so that vehicles in the long term have less total cost of ownership and in general can be used in more applications, whether that's B2C or B2B.
What does the future of mobility look like in your eyes?
It's going to be micromobility, it's going to be digital, it's going to be efficient and sustainable.
Thank you so much, Anna. And I will now find out why batteries are so important for the LEV industry. And I'm sitting here with two experts, Kevin and Gordon. And now, first asking you, what would you say is the current state of the battery technology?
Okay, the battery technology, as we know, is actually the enabling factor for us to see all the electrification of the transportation method, either it is EV or LEV. For example, so here we have a cylindrical cell from LG, which will bring the benefits of higher energy density, longer cycle life, and also to be much safer, so they can pass all the very difficult testing, such as nail penetration. So that will bring us all the benefits. So then this is from the material side, but then we also see the trend on the form factor of the battery.
So what do you think? How many people will actually ride purely electric in the upcoming years?
Well, that's a very good question. So we think there are about 20 million e-bike owners today in Europe. We think in the coming decades, there will be more and more people coming to start using LEVs.
Exactly, and not only the people that already have LEVs, but those that don't. And I think that's a really great market, and I'm really keen on seeing how this will expand. Yes. So Kevin, now turning to you, what would you say, what do batteries really need in order to be future-proof?
We need a better manufacturing process, not only a better battery, right? So which means we need to make that battery manufacturing process more reliable, more economical, and more green manufacturing line to save the waste, to save the energy. Because we are battery, we provide the energy, we cannot waste energy at the same time.
Thank you. And with this, I say thank you to Kevin and Gordon for your insights. And I think I've learned that for sure, without battery, there will be no light electric vehicles. And I'm delighted to see how Greenway will develop that even more. Thank you so much. And let's go. So light electric vehicles cannot only be used for private use, but also for commercial. So now I'll talk to Mochi and find out more about that. Hallihallo. So Ralf, thank you for having me here at your stand. Maybe you can explain us, what purpose is your Mochi bike being used for?
It was designed for last mile logistics, for delivery services, and also everything around craftsmen. So that's the scope that we have. We call this B2B, the B2B focus. Yeah. B2B for us means professional services, so it has to work. That's why also our claim, Mochi made to work. The innovation that we brought in here is made to reduce the total cost of ownership.
Maybe you can explain us first about the Mochi bike. Like, what exactly is so innovative about it?
If we just break it down, we have hardware innovation and software innovation. Hardware is everything that you see here, the chassis, so to speak. Yeah. We're doing this here in Germany to reduce also the CO2 footprint. Yeah. So that's the hardware side. Mm-hmm. And the software side is we have a digital drive unit. We have no mechanical connections in between. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so again, here to bring down the total cost of ownership. Yeah. And so all in all, this combined with IoT and a typical fleet management software, that's the customer offering.
Thanks a lot, Ralf, for your insights. And I really hope to see more Mochi bikes in the city center. Thank you. Hello, Tilman. It's so nice to see you. This really looks amazing. I want to now find out, because you're the founder of the Urban Mobility and this great cargo bike, what is it for?
Yeah, obviously we have a really traffic problem in urban areas, in city centers. And what we try with this vehicle, give operators the opportunity to move from trucks and bigger cars to such cargo bikes, just to save space, make mobility more agile. Yes, it's at the end, it's environmental friendly.
That definitely. And is it also electric?
Yes, it is. It is full electric. It's classified as a Pedelec 25, meaning it can go up to 25 kilometers per hour. Yes. That's a maximum and not more. And it's driven by electric motors. That's right.
Great. So what I'm going to do now is to try it out and to see how to ride it and if it's that easy. But I don't need a license to ride that, right?
No, you don't need a license. That is the classification as Pedelec 25. You don't need a license. You even don't have to wear a helmet. It's just for your own safety reasons.
Perfect. Then I'll try it out. Let's go. Thanks a lot. I mean, one can tell that I have quite a few weight on here, but it's really nice because, as you said, you have the opportunity to just move around and just get into the bike. So it's kind of like cycling, but also not really. So thank you so much, Tilman.
You're welcome.
So that was an incredible, fun LEV-themed day here at the Eurobike. I learned a lot, and I hope you did too. And see you next year at the Eurobike here in Frankfurt.